Time for a mic check with our guy Mike Kelly. And Mike, let's start in Calgary with Mark Giordano. He's back from that suspension. He's been scorching hot of late. Why, in your mind, does he have a legitimate case to win the Norris Trophy this season?
Oh, yeah, I absolutely think he does. I mean, he brings it in every facet of the game. He plays every facet of the game, which is important. And he's been so good this season. He eats a ton of minutes for this team. He goes up against the other team's top lines on a nightly basis. He'll kill penalties for you. He's on the power play for you. We all know how good Calgary's been this season, the kind of team success they're having. And he is such a massive part of it. He can do a little bit of everything for this team. You look at the fact that he's averaging about a point a game this season, a little over a point a game, second amongst all defensemen. He's got the puck on his stick at a top 10 rate amongst all defensemen. You want an outlet pass, you want to get the puck out of your zone and up the ice. He is phenomenal in that area, completing a high percentage of those passes, active in his own end, like I talk about with all these block passes, 10th amongst defensemen. And then while he's on the ice, this inner slot shot differential, which looks at the real high danger chances, which way are they going when he's on the ice? Above 60% for the Calgary Flames, which is right up there amongst the league leaders. Giordano is doing everything for this team this year. And a couple of years ago, he had a real shot at the Norris Trophy. He had an injury that ended up costing him the season and ultimately the Norris Trophy. But 35 years old, and I think right now, for me anyways, he's the favorite.
In Anaheim, Ondrej Kase has been playing very, very well. He scored a hat trick last night against the Stars. What's been clicking for him?
He's a great young player, and I don't think he's a household name at this point, EJ, but he's somebody that a lot of people know about. And I think the more that he gets a role on this team and the bigger his role gets on this team, the more people are going to know about him. He skates well. He's hungry for the puck. And he's just one of those guys that's able to find himself in the right positions at the right times. And so you look at the fact that he's only averaging about 15 minutes of ice a night. If you take a look at what he does at even strength and you normalize the numbers per 20 minutes across the league, he really shows well. He's got the puck a ton in the offensive zone, top five in the NHL. The only guys ahead of him are Barzal, Goudreau, really, really good players. Slot shots on net, getting these quality looks on net. Again, he's top five in the league at a per 20 rate at even strength. Zone entries, zone exits, his ability to transition the puck, he's a top 20 rate. And then top 35 as well in terms of even strength scoring. So when I look at this, I see a guy that if he gets a little bit more of a role, if he gets those numbers kicked up maybe to 18, 19 minutes a night, it's not a given that he'll continue to produce at those at that rate. But when you see cases like this, you say, okay, maybe this guy needs a bit more of a shot because he's been doing such a great job. And the Ducks have really turned their season around since he's come back in the lineup.
Tonight, all eyes will be on Tampa as the Lightning gets set to host the Maple Leafs, Mike. What key matchup stands out to you that you'll be kind of keeping an eye on in this one?
Well, there's so many of them, right? I mean, you've got the goaltending of Vasilevsky and Anderson. You've got elite players in terms of Marner and Kucherov and Matthews and Stamkos and Hedman and Riley. You go up and down. So what is going to give one team an edge in this game? I'm looking at the fact that the Tampa Bay Lightning, we all know how good offensively this team is. You look at the ranks this season, they get a fair amount of shots. They get a ton of quality shots on net from the house, over 17 per game, and they generate more scoring chances off the rush than any team. All good, high-scoring teams get a lot of looks with speed. Tampa Bay does it. Now you look at the Toronto Maple Leafs and how they're playing lately. These are their statistics since December 1st, their last five games. They are giving up a lot of shots on net. They are giving up a ton of shots from that high danger slot area, and only one team in the league is giving up more chances off the rush than the Toronto Maple Leafs. They can score a lot, and that can cover some of these problems, which they've been able to do. Frederik Andersen is capable of winning them games. He's been unbelievable. But when I look for what's going to be a potential difference in this game, I see that the Leafs have been a little bit leaky lately. And in those five games that we just looked at, what they've done lately, only one of the teams they played in that stretch, Minnesota, is in the top half of the league of the NHL in goals per game. Tampa Bay's number one, so they can make you pay in a big way. I think that could be a difference.
All right, Mike. It's going to be a good one tonight there in Tampa. Thanks for your time, buddy. We'll talk to you next week.
No problem. Thanks, EJ.